Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this brown box. This is an interestingly named Ubiquiti product. This is the Ubiquiti Swiss Army Knife Ultra, also known as the UK-Ultra. We'll maybe probably refer to it as that. It's interesting in this world where we are moving into wireless 6, wireless 6E and wireless 7 that Ubiquiti would launch a wireless 5 product. This is it here. I do actually think it has a place in the market. I'm not going to give you a big technical overview, but let's show you what's in the box first. So you are going to get a small conformity guide. There you go. Probably won't come out of the packing, I expect. You are going to get a drilling guide. All right, because there are a varying number of ways that this can be fitted onto a wall, onto a ceiling plate, onto a post, and we'll explore some of these as we go along. We are going to get a suspended ceiling bracket. So I'll show you, so in a moment we'll have a look at the back of this and how this plate would work. But if we've got a suspended ceiling with a track and a tile, then we can put this plate above it and we can bolt the back, which I'll show you in a minute, through with the tile there in the middle. All right, and now we've got that mounted on the surface. So you're going to get a couple of bolts there to allow that to happen. You are going to get a packet of screws and lugs for putting that onto a hard surface. You are going to get a couple of zip ties because you can mount this to a pole directly as well. And you're going to get a tiny screw in here. And this is to hold the back plate in place if you want to. Right, so what is this? It's a wireless 5 device, right? Can do about 300 megasecond in 2.4 and somewhere around about 500 or so in the 5 gigahertz frequency. The design or idea for this is it to be versatile. Firstly, it's really small, which I like. There are, I believe, some new mount options coming in due course. There's going to be a little desk mount that you can put this on, so it could just go up on a desk point. And like I said, though, we've got mounting for pole, for ceiling, for hard surface. And we do have some expandability with the antennas, which I'll show you in a moment as well. So let me just hold that up so you can actually see the device there. If the camera will focus on it, there we go. All right, not a lot really probably to show you on the bottom, although we'll open it up. This is where your little retaining screw will go to hold this back plate in place. We've got our LED indicators here on the side. And then on the top, we'll have a look here in a moment, but this is where you can take this off and put external SMA connectors for an antenna or something like that onto it. So there we go. There's the device. Let's have a look. So on the back here, all right, we've got our screw mounting and our main plate. So if we push in this button here, all right, we can, let the camera bring, there we go. We can take this plate off. So let's have a little look inside so that we can see what we've got. Up here, we've got our reset switch, and then we've got our single PoE port here in. Obviously, remember, there's no PoE inductor in the box, all right? So you do need to PoE power this, all right? And then, if I put my finger the right way, that's where our retaining screw will go. So there's very little actually inside the unit, 1 gig Ethernet connection. Then we've obviously got our back plate. You can probably just see here that we've got some just slight angle or ruffles there. Idea being we can pass our zip ties through this and mount that directly onto a pole. You can see here we've got our countersunk holes and for our screws. This would allow us to directly wall mount it like that. Alternatively, put our bolts through and use this on a false ceiling tile option there as well like that. So we've got quite a lot of mounting options for that. Like I said, once this clips back into place, so if we have a look at the bottom, we actually have an opening here that we can pass our Ethernet cable to. It is actually got a split, which I quite like in this, so we can make that obviously through with an already terminated Ethernet plug on the end. And once that's clipped then back into place there, then we would be able to put our retaining screw in place to hold that. So that is our unit as it is. It's weather tight, so this can go outside. Great for alfresco areas, places like that. Really good option there or on a pole. And obviously will mesh with other Ubiquiti devices. Then on the top, like we said, we can take the cover off. All right, and we've got two RP SMA connectors. Now this is pretty, I hope the camera can focus. There we go. This is pretty interesting. Obviously we have the Ubiquiti AC mesh that has two of these antennas. So actually, in fact, I've just taken these off an AC mesh and we can put these on. You haven't been able to buy these as items on their own. There is talk on Ubiquiti's website that we can, there'll be antennas to fit on here. So my guess is we'll be able to get spares now for the AC mesh that we weren't able to get before. But there it is with our rabbit ears on it. Obviously our same change around that we could get with any of the other devices like the AC mesh. Obviously there's the UMAD, which is the directional antenna that you could get for the AC mesh. I would imagine that that could be fitted onto this as well. So like I said, it actually does become quite a universal device. We've got ceiling mount, indoor, outdoor, potentially desk coming later, external antennas. Obviously I know that the AC mesh ones work on there, and the UMA probably, the UMAD or whatever it's called, probably does as well. We've got weather tight, so it's a pretty universal device. So I do, like I said, think that there is maybe a place for this. So this is the Ubiquiti UK Ultra, also known as the Swiss Army Knife Ultra. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on network, firewall, and wireless devices. What do I need to set up and run a Ubiquiti network, or to run Unify Protect? So why don't you have a look at some of those, subscribe, and stay up to date.